HipHopSince1987.com. Terrell Thomas, Hip Hop Since 1987. As you can see, we out here live, Austin, Texas, South by Southwest 2018. I'm with a Texas legend, Gentleman that's been doing his thing on the mic for a long time. Goes by the name of Darrell Music. How you feeling?
Man, I'm feeling good, man. I just got out here. I just drove straight from Dallas. I literally just got out here in Austin right now.
Now, you know, you've come a long way from the ice cream, paint jobs, rocking it, and Get Big. I understand you got some new things in the work. Talk to me about that.
The Jump Back. Yeah, the Jump Back is a project I'm getting ready to drop. You know, somebody's coming out April 26th. But I'm about to get ready to put out a single before that. I got a lot of visuals dropping. You know, I got a lot of stuff popping right now. You know what I'm saying? Music, business, all type of stuff. You feel me?
Now, I remember when, you know, when your single hit the streets and took the nation by storm, a lot of cats didn't understand the music scene in Dallas. Talk to us about the music scene in Dallas and just how strong it is.
Well, it always been a music scene in Dallas, and it always been strong in our own city, but it wasn't really shaped to the world yet, you feel me? The world didn't know about Dallas. So, you know, fortunately, I was one that was able to break that bubble and come out of Dallas. And, you know, just coming out of the city is a big thing within itself. And now people feel to see the city, though. It's a lot of stuff going on. It's a lot of artists popping right now. It's a lot of producers popping. And now the world feel to see, like, what we got, you feel me? So that's another part of the Jump Back. It's for to be this whole Jump Back thing with the city as well.
Yeah. Now, talk to me about South by Southwest and let artists know why it's important to come out here, network, perform, and to get themselves heard.
Man, at the end of the day, you feel me, you need an audience, you know what I'm talking about? And a lot of artists are talented, you feel me? A lot of them don't got an audience, but they got talent. So this is the perfect place you come. Get in front of as many people as you want. Hell, you can do your thing anywhere out here. You can do your thing on the streets. You can do it at any venue, you feel me? I just say this is a good place to come network and just, you know, get yourself out there.
Now, I'm a cat that I love to merge the world of sports and hip-hop. I know you love to do the same. You were recently playing in the Adidas All-Star Game, doing your thing out there on Team 2 Chainz. Talk to me about that experience.
Shit, I had to go for 21. I was MVP out there. I wasn't even in shape either, you know what I'm talking about. But that was just like, that came out of me. I used to play ball, you know, back in high school. And, you know, me and a lot of the rappers be talking a lot of shit to each other anyway about who can hoop. But, you know, I got to see who can really hoop out there. So I got to do my thing. I was the East MVP. Snoop Dogg team won. I was on 2 Chainz team. And we just had a good time, you feel me? That just happened like maybe 2 weeks ago. And, I came away with the MVP.
I also understand you got something going on with the Dallas Cowboys. Cowboys. Talk to me a little bit about that.
Yeah, man. Shout out to Dallas Cowboys. Matter of fact, we got a cowboy right here, man. Shout out to homie Rico. But it's a collaboration deal, you know, where I'm doing with the merchandise and where I got my own brand and merged with the Cowboys. I'm designing merch, performing at pre-games, and we're going to probably get a halftime this year doing the anthems. Just, you know, it's just a lot of stuff. It's basically a hip-hop to NFL deal, the first one ever, you feel me? So, and it's only for to get bigger. This year is really when it's for the ignite, you know?
Now, I also know you have a really good friend that plays in the NFL by the name of Michael Crabtree.
Yeah.
Now today he'll be beginning a new chapter in his career. The Oakland Raiders decided to go ahead and let him go. Yeah, a lot of teams are already looking at him. I'm an Eagles fan.
I talk with Crab. Crab, you know, he was much, you know, expecting and wanting what happened today, because he got a chance to go to some different teams. You know, he talked about, you know, he can go to a variety of different teams. I ain't gonna say nothing on camera.
But let me ask you, if you had to choose, where would you like to see him suiting up?
He coming to the boys. And that's actually a chance that could happen. But definitely, that's my first. But you know, I could see him at Green Bay. I could see him at Arizona. You feel me? I could see him, really between those three teams. Those are the teams where I could see him. And he could play really anywhere. Oh, I could see him in Jacksonville too.
Okay, I could see him in Jacksonville.
You feel me? But he gonna do his thing. You know what I'm talking about? That's Crab at the end of the day, man. He got a new chapter that he's gonna start with it.
Now you out there right in the backyard with the Dallas Mavericks. Player Dennis Smith Jr. is looking pretty good. What are your thoughts on him in the future of the Mavericks?
I love him because he the first of his style that the Dallas Mavericks never had. Like, we ain't never really had no gunner like that. You know what I'm talking about? I always wanted a player like that for the Mavericks. Like, I don't really know how to explain it, but we ain't never really had a player like that, and that's a good thing with itself. And I see a bright future. You know, we're in a rebuilding process. So, but we got a good, you know what I'm saying, foundation we can build upon. So I think homie gonna be legit the next couple years, even this year, but the next 2 or 3 years, I can see him becoming an elite player in the NBA.
So we know you got a new project on the way. We know you got a new single on the way. What else can we expect from you as the year 2018 continues?
Man, this year, you feel me, the jump back gonna start off. I ain't gonna do too much talking. I'm gonna let the music and everything speak for itself, you know what I'm talking about? But the jump back on the way, that's the EP coming out April 26th. I'm gonna drop the new single March 23rd, the Kyle Law record, man. I got a lot of shit for the come, and I'm just gonna let that speak for itself.
Yeah. You know what it is, Terrell Thomas, Hip Hop Since 1987. We live right now, South by Southwest. Artists, if you're not here, I don't know what you got going on. Make sure you stay tuned to Hip Hop Since 1987, and we'll be bringing you a lot more music from this gentleman right here.
Yeah.
HipHop since 1987.com.